This is CHSTV News.
Good morning, Cathedral. I'm Alexa.
And I'm Kiara, with your morning announcements for Tuesday, May 1st.
Let's start off the show with the message from Hunter.
Good morning, Gales. I'm here to remind you again that this Friday is Red Shirt Day. Red Shirt Day is our way of remembering the indigenous women who are missing and who have been murdered, and currently there are over 500 of them. 75% of these women have been murdered, and 25% of these women are missing. Canada's women's homicide rate is 16%, with 10% of these being Indigenous women, yet Indigenous women only make up 3% of Canada's population. Earlier this school year, Nyawe was fortunate enough to be able to go to the Walking with Our Sisters exhibition at the Gathering Place by the Grand. This exhibition was dedicated to the missing and murdered Indigenous women of Canada. We saw beautiful pieces of art that were made by the family members of these missing women or murdered women. Like this exhibition, the purpose of Red Shirt Day is to spread awareness of an ever-growing cause of the injustice to these women whose killers and or kidnappers haven't been rightly punished. Please show your support for this cause by wearing a red shirt with your school uniform bottoms this Friday. That's it from me. Now back to the anchors.
Thanks, Hunter. Graduates, listen up. Applications for the Cathedral Student Enterprises bursaries are now available. These bursaries are valued up to $2,500 and are for Cathedral students who are not returning and moving on to post-secondary institution in September. Pick up an application form from the CSE office, room 312. The applications include a written component and reference letters. They are due no later than May 14th. See Mrs. D. Gregorio if you have any questions.
Applications for the Cathedral School Letter Award are now available in the guidance office. This prestigious award is given to students who have positively contributed to the spirit of our school in the areas of athletics, academics, and co-curricular. Please see Mr. Felice for your application. The due date is May 9th.
The latest order of spirit wear will be delivered to Period 1 classes this morning. Students with a Period 1 spare or co-op can get their order from Mr. Chibuco in room 103. All staff and students are asked to verify their items in their order. If there is a wrong size, color, or style, please go to room 103 and speak with Mr. Chibuco.
Attention grade 12 graduates. If you are interested in creating the artwork for your graduation mass program, please come see Ms. O'Keefe this week for the theme and ideas. And speaking of mass, we continue our Wednesday morning masses with Father Jay and Nesbitt tomorrow morning at 7:50 a.m. in our chapel. Join the junior boys soccer team for their team mass. All are welcome.
Students who are donating blood today are asked to please meet Ms. Charlton in front of the attendance office at 10:30. Please bring your photo ID, drink plenty of water, and eat well beforehand. Thank you for your life-saving contribution.
Summer school information and applications are now available in Student Services. If you have failed a course this year, you are strongly encouraged to go to summer school. If you are considering getting ahead with your credits, you can also register for summer school. Credits are earned through regular classroom with teacher instruction, or through e-learning, or through independent learning courses. Talk to your counselor about which type of learning is best suited to you. Summer school runs for the month of July here at Cathedral, Bishop Ryan, and St. Thomas More. Register early to avoid disappointment.
All students who signed up for the tennis team is reminded that there will be a tryout today from 3 to 4 p.m. at the Rosedale Tennis Club in Gage Park. Please be on time, dress appropriately, and bring a tennis racket. Thank you from the coaches.
Attention members of the track and field team. Practice today with Coach McPhee is at 3:30 at Brebeuf, and practice will also take place tomorrow at Brebeuf with Coach Verasso. This is all in preparation for the Mark Graham meet on Thursday at Mohawk Sports Park.
And to end off our show, I'll pass it over to some of the members of the Gale Guides.
Good morning, everyone. All this week, you'll be hearing announcements like these, promoting mental well-being, as May is Mental Awareness Month. One of the biggest ways we can improve our mental well-being is to connect with other people. It's important to start with the people who hit closest to home, our family. Whether it be taking half a minute to check up on your siblings or parents or sitting down together for family meals, build strong, healthy connections with your family members is integral to our mental well-being. A healthy environment at home alleviates a lot of stress, and having people who can be completely open can help you get a lot of things off your chest. After all, there's no place like home. The Ontario Catholic Graduate Expectation titled A Caring Family Member reminds us to relate to our family members in a long, compassionate, and respectful manner. We'll be back with other ways to connect with others all this week. Now I'll pass it over to Mr. Pustad.
Good morning. Thank you so much. Good morning, Cathedral. Yes, today marks the beginning of Mental Health Awareness Month. And our hope here is not only to begin a campaign, in a movement. And throughout the month of May, different organizations within our school community will be presenting activities and presentations, and I invite you to participate as much as possible. In the last week or so, we've been asking you to let your teachers know your t-shirt size, because each member of staff, every student, everyone in this school will be receiving a t-shirt which will say Gales for Gales. That's Gales supporting Gales. Not supporting mental illness, but supporting mental health and mental well-being. And so we will be having an assembly at the end of the month, not only to celebrate the culmination of all the wonderful activities that will go on in hope of solidifying mental health and mental well-being in staff and students, but we hope that those t-shirts will be worn proudly on spirit days and on other occasions where we need to support one another. Gales for Gales, Gales supporting Gales towards mental health and mental well-being. And more information about that assembly will be forthcoming, but again, please partake in many of the activities. They're not only enjoyable, but they also teach us valuable lessons in how we can strengthen our own mental health and mental well-being, not only in the month of May, but throughout the year and in the years to come. So happy May to everyone. We look forward to seeing you soon. Now back to the desk.
Thanks, sir.
And those are all of your announcements for today, Cathedral.
Have a great day, Gales, and thanks for watching.